The 10 points, if I highlight, are South Indian states have higher literacy rate than North Indian states. Coastal region have the higher literacy rate than the continental region. The cash crop region have the higher literacy rate than the intensive food grain subsistence farming. Urban centers have the higher, urban centers and its periphery is having higher literacy rate than the remote areas, the agricultural areas, where the food grain crops, rice cultivated area is having low literacy rate, and then the wheat growing area. So both are the food grain areas in the country. South India have the higher urban rate, higher rate of urbanization than the North India. So the higher literacy rate in South India than the North India. So literacy, urban pattern is greatly influencing the literacy rate. The mechanization in agriculture is also influencing the literacy rate, where the mechanization level in agriculture and farm sector is high, literacy rate is also high. Where the mechanization is less in farm sector, where requirement of labor is more, so we have the low literacy rate. So these are the 10-12 regional parameters of the literacy rate. The backward states, state with low literacy rate, they are registering the faster growth now. States who have achieved the maximum literacy rate, they have the slow increase in their literacy rate. So these are the points I wanted to say. So after this, I also wanted to share something more about the age structure and the labor structure. But this topic I will take it later. Now come over to the next topic, that is the resources of India, the mineral resources of India, the distribution of mineral resources. Resources. Of India. Resources may be natural resources. In natural, basically we have the forest resources, like you can say soil resources, soil as a resource. We have the land resource, land is the prime resource. We have the livestock is the important resource, and after that mineral resources. In the minerals, we have three types of minerals: metallic minerals, non-metallic minerals, and the fossil fuel minerals. While discussing the like some metallic, we have like iron, ore is the mineral, copper is the mineral, like bauxite is the mineral. These are the example of metallic minerals. Non-metallic are, you can say, mica is there, gypsum is there, and the fossil means coal is there, petroleum is there. So this is the pattern of distribution of minerals. Let's take iron ore. This is the prime mineral resource, natural resource. And in India, we have the different types of iron ore. The ore, types of ore, or the best type of ore is called hematite, magnetite. Siderite, limonite, pyrite, So these are the different types. Typology is based on the ore content in these ores, the content, iron content in these ores, or iron content in these ores, it is 85% plus. This is approximately 80% plus. It is having say 40% plus. It is only 30% plus, and this is less than 25% and less. So these three types of iron ore are not good for extraction because their extraction cost is higher than its manufacturing cost. The ore we extract, it is called gangue. G-A-N-G-U-E, gangue. Gangue is the mix of iron ore content, variety of salts, calcium, magnesium, sodium, variety of salts. It is all together, all you can say, all kind of impurities are called gangue, and we extract it. We have the technology to segregate it. So basically, in India, it is good that we have the either the hematite or the magnetite. India is one of the leading producer of iron ore in the world. India is the fourth largest producer of iron ore in the world after Brazil, Australia, Russia and China. India has exceeded USA now, because in USA Mesabi Range iron ore mines are closed now. So India is the fourth largest producer and exporter, and we are exporting basically iron ore to USA. We have three ports are exclusively developed to export the iron ore. One was the Paradip, one was the Goa, you can say Marmagao, and the third was Vishakhapatnam. These ports were basically developed to export the iron ore from India. So where iron ore found in the country, basically all the metallic or mineral resources in the country, they all found in the peninsular plateau. They get deposited gradually with the course of time, and most of the iron ore, if you see the distribution of iron ore in the country, distribution of iron ore, then you can understand, if distribution is there, you can understand the iron and steel industry. Quickly I'll give you the pattern of this iron ore. Maximum iron ore concentration found in the southern CNP, southern Chota Nagpur plateau, and it is basically Jharkhand, and in Jharkhand it is basically Singhbhum district. In Singhbhum district, basically few mines, the name of the mines are
Bokaro,
Bua, one of the largest iron ore mine, Noamundi, Barajap, then one is called Jamda, Barajamda. Notuburu, so these are the important mines of Singhbhum district. Apart from that, in southern Chota Nagpur plateau, we have Odisha. In Odisha, basically three districts, one is called Keonjhar, Sundargarh, and Mayurbhanj.
Mayurbihar.
They are in the northern Odisha, adjacent to Singhbhum. So there are some important mines from where we extract the iron ore. there is the mine called Kiriburu. Kiriburu is one of the probably the second largest mine of Chotanagpur Plateau. From here, Kiriburu mines, we have constructed a railway line up to, and that railway line connected to Paradeep iron ore. Paradeep is mean. We export the iron ore from Paradeep from here, from the Kiriburu mines. Guru Mahisani. Sulaipat. But I use the word part. Partland, plain topography, after peniplanation, this table land has converted to planation. That planation after erosion is called part. So it is Sulaipat, Badam Pahad. Sulaipat, Kiriburu, Guru Mahisani, some mine like Thakurni, there is, these are the important mines of Odisha. So Guru Mahisani is one of the largest mine, Guwa, Guru Mahisani and Kiriburu. Because Guru Mahisani supplied iron ore to TISCO plant. TISCO was established in 1912. So more than 100 years continuously TISCO is extracting iron ore from Guru Mahisani mine. So it is good quality hematite iron ore. So if I construct the this is the coastal region of India. This is Odisha, this is Odisha region here, and this is Singhbhum. Singhbhum. So these are the mines here, and these are the mines here. These are the three districts. You can say this is the district called Mayurbhanj. This is Kyonjhar, and this is Sundargarh. Mayurbhanj, Kyonjhar and Sundargarh. So in these three districts, and this is Singhbhum district. So West Singhbhum near Saraikela. So this is, these are the mines. And here we have a Paradeep port. Paradeep is, so we have constructed a railway line connecting Paradeep to Kiriburu. And from Kiriburu, we export the Paradeep to Japan. Japan is the largest importer of Indian iron ore. So we use to export Kiriburu to this. So this is the one region in Odisha and Singhbhum, the northern districts. Here they are known for the iron ore deposits over here. Apart from that, in India, basically, iron ore is also extracted in Chhattisgarh, or you can say CG. Chhattisgarh is one of the state, you can say here. It is like this, and here this is the railway line connecting Mumbai to Kolkata. This is also the national highway. This is, you can say, Raipur. This is Durg, Raipur. The southern part is called Bastar Plateau and northern part is called Sarguja Plateau or the Amarkantak Plateau. So in Bastar Plateau, there are the mines. The southern mine, and this is another mine. This is called Dalli Rajhara and Rao Ghat. There are the two mines, Rao Ghat and Dalli Rajhara. This city is called Bhilai. Bhilai steel city. So Bhilai take iron ore from Dalli Rajhara. And this is Bailadila. Bailadila is the one of the oldest and the good quality, best quality of iron ore from where we used to export iron ore. We are exporting Balladila iron ore since British period. Britishers constructed a railway track all the way. Suppose this is the Andhra Pradesh. This is the Vizag. From Vizag they have constructed the railway line through the eastern ghat, because this is all eastern ghats are there. So through the eastern ghat, very zigzag railway track. This is all naxal prone area basically present. This entire area is naxal prone area. Entire Bastar Plateau. So from Balladila, we have Britishers constructed this railway line to the remotest part of the country, basically uninhabited part of the country. Basically, this is primitive people, the tribal people, the Baga people, Birhor people, Abuzmad people. Abuzmad, you must be knowing, is a tribe in Bastar region. So in uninhabited region, tribal, forested, dense forest, mountainous, eastern ghats. But we Britishers constructed this railway track just to extract the Balladila best quality of iron ore. And unfortunately, we have not been able to connect railway track this from this side. So if we need to come over here, we have to come all the way to this railway track. We go to Odisha, take a huge round, and then we come over. So there is no railway connectivity between Raipur, Bhilai and Balladila. So for to come over here, we have to take complete round of Visakhapatnam, Pipli, Patali, Ghat, then it comes all the way through Odisha. So because of the tribal, Naxal people nowadays, they have created problem for their connectivity. So Balladila and Dali Rajhara and Rao Ghat are the other mines over here in Chhattisgarh. And in Jharkhand, Singhbhum. In Singhbhum, I mentioned some of the mines. In Odisha, Northern Odisha, I mentioned some of the important names of the mines in the districts. Now come over to the Karnataka. Karnataka is another very important state. If I make this is the western coast of India, this is Karnataka, and in Karnataka this is one of the region. You can say this is Raichur. Just north of Raichur, this is one area, mining is full of iron ore mines. What is the name of this region? Hospet. Bellary. And Donai Malai. Basically, Hospet and Bellary region. Located in the extreme northeastern part of the Karnataka, and the southwestern part of Karnataka. Southwestern means there is one steel plant here. You know, Visakhapatnam is also having this steel plant, so it obtained iron ore from Balladila. And we have a steel plant here. In this part of Karnataka, can you name this steel plant? Vijayanagar steel plant. Vijayanagar steel plant. There is one steel plant near these mines. This is Bhadravati steel plant over here. So because of the availability of iron ore. So this is called region called Keman Gundi. Baba Budan Hills. Then there is a mine called Kudremukh. And from here we have, from Kudremukh, it's a small area, not that big area. From Kudremukh we have constructed a special conveyor belt up to Mangalore port. This is the port called Mangalore port. From Kudremukh all the way from Western Ghat, a conveyor belt runs up to 12 km and supply the iron ore to the port, and this is one of the Keman Gundi, one of the largest iron ore mines in South India. So this is Keman Gundi, Baba Budan Hills, there is some other names, Bandar Pahad and Kudremukh, but I may say Bandar Pahad. These are the important mines. Either in northeast, we have the Vijayanagar steel plant, or in the southwest, we have the Bhadravati steel plant, and we also export from Mangalore. Mangalore is also iron ore exporting port of the country. So this is about the Karnataka. Apart from Karnataka, this is a small state here. This is called Goa. And Goa is the state with the parallel drainage pattern. If I say this is Goa, here, this is Panaji or Panjim. Panaji. If it is Panjim, it is called P-A-N-J-I. It is Panjim or Panaji. There are the rivers. This is the coast. This river is a big river called Mandovi River. And this river is called Juari River. And this is Vasco City. And this is Debolim Airport. From here, the runway, jab aircraft land karta hai, to bilkul it is very close to the beach, aise lagta sea mein utar jayega. So it is sometimes, you know, these are the tidal rivers. These rivers are the having the estuary, they make the estuary. These rivers, when the high tide comes, water enters up to the interior. So there are the mines. Mines close to these rivers. So these rivers provide the cheap transport facility. They supply the cheap water transport facility to supply the port is here near Vasco. This is the port. The name of the port is called Marmagao Port. Marmagao Port, and Marmagao Port was developed to export the iron ore. So small steamers, small ships, they transport the entire the iron ore and upload it at Marmagao Port, and from here we export. So there are this is, though it is the smallest port, 3 years ago, no, 2 years ago, there was the, we undertook the long excursion to Goa, because in the current past, Supreme Court put the carpet ban on the mining or extraction of iron ore because of environmental hazards. Large scale, the large land on the large scale is, after mining, converted into wasteland. Entire area is turned into a barren land. And they, where the deep holes are constructed, free from vegetation, free from water supply, free from soil, free from habitat. So everything was disturbed by this mining. So the Supreme Court put the ban and fixed the limitation that this is the amount, and you can extract only this limited amount of the iron ore. Then they put a kind of rationing and proper accounting of the mining, so the environment could be protected of the area. So we studied, the students of the geography department 2 years ago went over there, visited to the sites, mining sites, and interacted with the people and the environmentalists over there. The local people who lost their job because of the complete ban on the mining, they were crying. And the people who are the environmentalists, they were really happy. So they said, the people who have purchased the trucks, 1, 2, 3, some of the people were having more than a dozen trucks. So they were supplying iron ore from the mines to the small ship and from small ship to the bigger ships. All the times the roads were all the time packed. Local people were crying that every time trucks are going moving here. So they have created problem. There was a kind of iron ore mining mafia was working over there. So at large scale economically it was the setback on the economy of Goa, because 50% of the population of Goa, they become unemployed overnight with the one decision of the Supreme Court. So that increased the poverty rate, unemployment, out migration from Goa have started taking place because of this this decision. So we worked over there. So there are the mines called, some of the important mines called Pirna mines. Pirna, Kosti, COSTI, Netarlim, Sanquelim, Netarlim, Sanquelim, Pirna, Kosti, because these rivers provide cheap navigation from the interior of the Western Ghats, from the rugged topography, and they are, so these names are sufficient to recall, though there are some more names I may give, but it will create some confusion. Well, this is in Goa, Sanquelim, Pirna, Kosti and Netarlim. Though these are the important mining centers of iron ore in the country, the Jharkhand, Odisha, Chhattisgarh, Karnataka and Goa. Apart from this, iron ore also found in the country in Maharashtra, in Madhya Pradesh around Jabalpur, in Maharashtra around Nagpur. Also iron ore found in Karnataka around Salem, because Salem steel plant is there. But that is of inferior quality of iron ore, and that iron ore is in limited quantity. But these are the major iron ore mining centers of the country. So broadly I can just construct one small. I hope you cannot forget all these names you have noted down. So this is the, again in the broad view, these are the names of the iron ore mines. So this is the Goa. From here, what is the name of this port?
Marmagao
port. And this is another port called Mangalore. From here, from where it obtained iron ore? Kudremukh. Actually, we started. We established iron ore oil refinery at Mangalore with the agreement that Iran will supply iron petroleum to India, to this refinery, and India will sell iron ore to Iran. But that agreement was breached later by Iran in early 80s. So that's why we started this port to export it to Iran. So it obtained from Goa itself. Apart from that, some area around Ratnagiri. Ratnagiri is also important iron ore mining center over here. Dhanganwadi, Jhalawadi, and Ratnagiri and Sawantwadi. These are the important places. But need not to just mention the name. Here I will say Vizag. Vizag. Also, we used to export and we import in Vizag. Iron ore comes from
Bellary.
And one more port is called Paradip. And Paradip, it is in Odisha. Iron ore comes from which mine?
Singbum.
I said Kiriburu mine. Kiriburu mine is on border. This is in mining area, one area. This is Jharkhand and this is Odisha. So the mine spread over in both the area. So it is on the border, Kiriguru. From Kiriguru,